Hi everyone, I'm Lee Sun. I'm a candidate for Sembawang GRC in this general election. And together with Mariam, we are here to learn from our veterans how to run a GRC. So, a couple of questions for them this morning.
Let's go.
So we have with us, Lin Ong Yee Kang, Mr. Vikram Nair, and Dr. Lim Wee Kiat.
One term, two terms, three terms.
That's right.
No, I'm more than one term.
Yeah.
I always count the term I lost.
Always count the term you lose.
Because your education started there.
See, that's the problem with our society. We don't count the setbacks. We must always count the setbacks.
First question, maybe I'll ask the most senior MP, Dr. Lim.
Still young, ah?
Yeah. You started young. What are the day-to-day duties of an MP?
Wow. A lot leh. Mm. You want to list down everything.
The most important one.
I think at the end of it, our most important preoccupation is to look after the residents. Mm. Especially what is the needs on the ground now, what are the current issues. We also play a very important role in terms of performing a bridge between government as well as the people on the ground. So we do this through multiple platforms. Meet the people session. Now, of course, emails, they send it to you directly. We do interact with our residents through the different activities, whether block parties, you know, you can have floor parties, you can have major events like festive activities. But all these events, through these events itself, you can get feedback. People will walk up to you, talk to you, give you their feedback. Then during our speeches, you know, on all these events itself, yes, we make it a point to communicate policies. But at the same time, after that communication, important thing is to watch out for a reaction, look at what residents really feel about it, then provide frank, timely feedback to the government.
But that sounds a bit like a model answer, Lee. So, can you share with us some more real-life example?
Oh, okay, like, I can.
You are seeing struggle, okay.
Wait, it's lawyer, I defend him now.
Okay, lawyer. Okay, one education minister give you 6 upon 10. You come out with illustration, maybe I consider 9 upon 10.
This game is called This or That. So you have to choose between two choices and then tell us why. Physical rally or Facebook Live?
Physical rally.
Why?
Gathering more heat, more people you can see, and then we have fun.
And then you can speak to Jude, right?
Yes.
That's something I feel a bit bad for both of you. Because your first election, you don't have a physical rally. Actually, you must have a physical rally at some point. Because then you feel the energy of the crowd, and then you take it in, and then you say what you want to say. That is important skill and an important experience at some point you must have. Mm. Yeah. And you can't do that on e-rally. You will look very strange.
You can't get a camera to respond to it in front of you.
When you speak to people and you look at their expression and where they clap, where they laugh, and that energizes you.
Actually, I mean, you know, I think working with the government means things at different levels. One is, of course, at Parliament you raise things. But for me, actually, some of the biggest differences you can make is just talking to the local agencies. So, for example, when I first came in, you know, one of the first things the residents told me is, wow, waiting for a bus to go MRT so long. 901, you know, the frequency is very low. So what did we do? We waited with our volunteers at the bus stop where, you know, the biggest bottleneck was, got the LTA down to wait with us, check the timing, check how long, verify the residents' feedback, put up requests for more services, and through that we managed to increase the frequency of the 901 bus service to, you know, less than 10-minute waiting time during peak hours.
One of your unwritten rules is to be able to work with government agencies.
Yes.
Government agencies, imagine your LTA, 93 constituencies next time, all want new buses, no? Everyone also want MRT station. How are they going to prioritize? Yeah. So you must be able to work with them and convince them that my area need a bit of priority, need a bit of take care of it a bit, you know, how to optimize. The law only give you two legal obligations, as far as I know. One is you lead the town council. The town council maintain the place. Mm. Yeah? They do their cleaning, if there are rats, they catch, lift, maintenance, all that. And in return, we have the authority to collect SC&C charges from residents. Yeah? That's one. That's a legal responsibility. Mm. Another legal responsibility is that in Parliament, you speak for residents. Mm. And how you speak is different, you know? Mm. So, Madam Lee Bee Hua, Engineer Lee Bee Hua will say in a certain way, will speak for residents in a certain way. And then other MPs will will raise issues in their own way. So it also depends on your personal conviction. But beyond that, I think that is only 30% of an MP's work. Beyond that, you've got 70% that is voluntary, up to you, and up to your own initiative. And you can go way beyond what the MP require. No, there's no legal obligation for us to do MPS, but we've been doing it. It's a practice, you have to do it. No legal obligation to do hawker center visit or block visit, but we do that. Because if not, you cannot perform your two obligations well. You must understand what residents are thinking of, what are the problems, down to which drain is choked, where got mosquito, you have to know. So if you have an MPS next time, and you find your MPS very crowded, be happy. At least residents are coming to you for help. The day they don't come is when we have failed.
So I guess as newbies, we really got to start off knowing our ground really well.
Yes, what the residents really want. Otherwise, you have nothing to start with.
But I would say that whatever we voice out in Parliament, it actually represents less than 10% of what we really sort of feedback to the government.
That's right.
It's not that because you're an MP, you voice out a lot in Parliament, you do much more compared to those who didn't voice out in Parliament. In fact, a lot of us sort of work behind the scene, in the sense that we can email directly to the ministers, we actually sort of discuss with them. Policies are like just like medicine. All medicines got side effects at the end of it. You know, so majority of this medicine, I think most people, when they take it, they are all right. Very few of them may get adverse side effects. And the question is now, how do you deal with these adverse side effects now? And to the resident, whatever you do for me and my family, it doesn't matter. You don't talk to me about policy. If the policy affects me, it affects me. You know, I can understand your policies is for majority, but now it affects me. What are you going to do for me?
I think now you're 9 upon 10.
That's most important.
Last words of advice.
I think all the best. Good luck. Issue now is that this is going to be a marathon. So this is not a 100 meter sprint. Take care of yourself. If you can't take care of yourself, you can't take care of the residents or so. Then make sure that you go all the way.
I mean, there's a lot of hard work involved. You know, try and find balance. And don't forget your family and loved ones in the process as well.
Whatever you do, do with a smile. Okay?
Thank you
so
much.
This
one never smiles.
Well, I don't. I'm terrible at that. I'm terrible at that.
Only not in front of cameras.
He's smiling inside.
But you see, after you've been in politics for a while, people forgive you for not smiling. Because it's just your face.
He's smiling inside. It's okay. So we understand.